Good morning, students. Welcome to the next class. So in the last class, we have discussed some simplified formulas to solve the practical problems of the ANOVA one-way classification. And we have started how to find the expectation for the various sum of squares in our ANOVA one-way classification. So we are going to find the expectation for the sum of squares to obtain the appropriate test statistic for our analysis. So, expectations of sum of squares, the total sum of squares is partitioned into two sum of squares, that is sum of squares due to treatment and also sum of squares due to error. So, we will be finding expectation of sum of squares due to treatment and also expectation of sum of squares due to error. So before that, we have done some simplifications in the last class, that is, first the linear model. What is the linear model we have written? Yij equals to mu plus alpha I plus epsilon ij. This one we have considered at equation 1. So for this linear model, we took summation over j and divided by ni so that we got the equation as y I dot bar equals to mu plus alpha I plus epsilon I dot bar. This one we have considered as equation 2. And after that, for the linear model, we took the summation over I and j combined and divided with capital N so that we got the equation y double dot bar is equals to mu plus epsilon double dot bar. So this one we have considered as equation 3. So we have done up to this. Next is, since we know that the error, whatever the error is there, that is epsilon ij follows the IID normal variable with mean 0 and variance sigma e square. So error always except the basic assumptions of the error also is error follows the errors are the IID normal variables with mean 0 and variance sigma e square. So mean 0 means expectation of epsilon ij equals to 0 and variance of epsilon ij is equals to sigma e square. So we always know normal distribution parameters will be whatever the parameters is there. The first parameter is mu, that is considered as mean. The second parameter is sigma square, that is variance. So your mean value is equals to 0 and variance value is equals to sigma e square for all the I and j values. Now we consider the variance of Eij. So consider the variance of Eij. So generally, what is the formula for variance of Eij? Variance is expectation of Eij square minus expectation of Eij whole square. We have the variance formula, right? What is the variance formula? Variance of x equals to expectation of x square minus expectation of x whole square. So by using that formula, variance of Eij is equals to expectation of Eij square minus expectation of epsilon ij whole square. So we know that expectation of epsilon ij equals to 0. So variance of epsilon ij is equals to expectation of Eij, that is epsilon ij square, since expectation of epsilon ij is equals to 0. Since this value equals to 0, the variance of Eij is equals to expectation of Eij square. So what is the variance value? We know variance of Eij, sigma e square. So therefore, we get that expectation of epsilon ij square
0.
Now we got the expected values of epsilon I dot bar, epsilon double dot bar. We also want the variances for these values. So now we find out the variance of these values. So first consider the variance of EI epsilon I dot bar. Consider variance of epsilon I dot bar. So what is the variance formula generally? We know what is EI dot bar value. What is EI dot bar? Which is equals to variance of 1 by Ni summation over j equals to 1 to Ni epsilon ij. Epsilon I dot bar is the ith treatment error value, right? That is 1 by Ni. Total Ni values will be there. Summation j equals to 1 to Ni epsilon ij. So here what is the constant? 1 by Ni is constant. The variance of a constant is its square. So this is equals to 1 by Ni square variance of summation j equals to 1 to Ni epsilon ij. So we know that whenever we have the formula variance of x plus y is equals to variance of x plus variance of y if x and y are independent. The covariance term will become 0, right? So similarly here it is summation, right? Epsilon I1 plus epsilon I2 plus so on epsilon in. So this also can be written in this form, that is variance of x plus variance of y. So since they are independent, so this is nothing but summation of variance of x, that is x and variance of x plus variance of y. Together we write summation. Like that only here we can write this is equals to 1 by Ni square summation j equals to 1 to Ni variance of epsilon ij. So now we know the variance of epsilon ij value. What is the value? Sigma e square. So substitute that value, which is equals to 1 by Ni square summation over j equals to 1 to Ni. Variance of epsilon ij is, the value is sigma e square. Substitute sigma e square. Now coming to the summation, summation j equals to 1 to Ni means total Ni values. So variance of epsilon I dot bar is equals to 1 by Ni square into, this summation can be written as Ni into sigma E square. So here Ni and 1 Ni gets cancelled. So therefore variance of epsilon I dot bar is equals to 1 by Ni sigma E square. So variance of epsilon I dot bar is equals to sigma e square by Ni. So we know variance here, if you observe, variance of Eij is equals to expectation of Eij square. Similarly here variance of Ei dot bar will be equals to expectation of Ei dot bar square. Because Ei dot bar expectation is also 0. Here also expectation of Eij equals to 0. That's why variance of Eij equals to expectation of Eij square. Similarly like that only variance of Ei dot bar equals to expectation of epsilon I dot bar whole square, that is equals to 1 by Ni sigma E square. So copy it here. Now we got the variance of Ei dot bar. Next we consider the variance of E double dot bar. So now consider variance of epsilon double dot bar. You can call it as epsilon or E. So just to avoid the confusion, expectation also we will write E of, right? So don't get confused, you can write epsilon or you can call it as epsilon, or if you don't have confusion, you can write E of. So variance of epsilon double dot bar equals to, what is the formula for the epsilon double dot bar? That is variance of 1 by capital N. This is the overall mean of the error, right? So 1 by N summation I equals to 1 to k, summation j equals to 1 to ni, epsilon I j. So now 1 by n is constant. So if 1 by n is constant, the variance of a constant is its square. So 1 by n square. So here also same logic that they are independent, right? So whenever the variables are independent, variance of summation of xi equals to summation of variance of xi. So we will write both the summations outside, that is summation I equals to 1 to k, summation j equals to 1 to ni, variance of epsilon ij. Since eij are independent, so now we know the variance of Eij value. What is the variance of Eij value? Sigma E square. So this is equals to 1 by n square double summation I equals to 1 to k, j equals to 1 to n I. This is sigma E square. Now this is equals to 1 by n square summation over I equals to 1 to k. This can be written as summation j equals to 1 to ni means total ni values into sigma e square. Since we know that capital N equals to summation over I ni, so in place of this we can write capital N into sigma e square. So N and N gets cancelled, therefore variance of epsilon double dot bar is equals to 1 by capital N sigma e square. So variance of epsilon double dot bar is equals to what? Expectation of epsilon double dot bar square. So similarly, the same logic what we have applied here. Since its p value equals to 0, that's why variance will be equal to the expectation of the square value. So remember these values. So we have considered the variance of epsilon I dot bar and also the variance of epsilon double dot bar. So copy till here. Next is, we have to remember some notations for the epsilon. So all the epsilon formulas we'll write once, so that which will be useful in deriving the expectations. Epsilon I dot bar. Next also, One more thing is, we have epsilon double dot bar equals to 1 by n summation I equals to 1 to k, and in place of summation over j equals to 1 to n epsilon ij. So here summation over j equals to 1 to n I epsilon ij, and in place of that you can write n I into epsilon I dot bar. So epsilon double dot bar can also be written as like this. This can be written as n into epsilon double dot bar equals to summation over I equals to 1 to k n I into epsilon I dot bar. So remember these three formulas for doing the further calculations. So from the above results, we will calculate the expectation of various sum of squares. So first we will start with the expectation of sum of squares due to treatments. It is partitioned into two parts, right? Treatments and errors. So first we will find the treatment.
Equals to 1 to k
in I. So first a square, that is alpha I square, plus b square, that is epsilon I dot 1 minus epsilon double dot 1 whole square, plus 2 into ab, that is alpha I into epsilon I dot 1 minus epsilon double dot 1. Yes. Now we will multiply this summation I equals to 1 to k ni to all the terms separately, and we will at the same time we apply the expectation for each and every term also. If you observe the first term, ni and alpha i's are constant. We will be getting expectations only for the errors, right? So these two are constant. So first term will be expectation of a constant is constant itself. So ni alpha I square plus here summation I equals expectation of the second term, that is summation I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon I dot bar minus epsilon double dot bar whole square plus 2 into expectation of summation I equals to 1 to k ni alpha I into epsilon I dot bar minus epsilon double dot bar. So for three terms we have multiplied the summation ni and also applied the expectation to all the terms separately. Now if you observe, in the third term we have summation ni alpha I. So in the note point only we have written that summation ni alpha I value will be equals to 0. So the complete third term will become 0 and the remaining terms we will be getting as summation I equals to 1 to k ni into alpha I square plus expectation of summation I equals to 1 to k, this ni into epsilon I dot minus epsilon double dot bar whole square can be written as ni into epsilon I dot bar square minus capital N into epsilon double dot bar square. So have we got this one? Now I'll show in the since part. So since this value is summation I equals to 1 to k ni alpha I equals to 0, the third term will become 0. Second term you will be getting as summation ni epsilon I dot bar square minus n into epsilon double dot bar square. So have we got this one? Now we will see in the since part. So first copy till here. Now since, so consider that second term. What is the second term? Summation I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon I dot bar minus epsilon double dot bar whole square. Now u, this is in the form of again a minus b whole square. So summation I equals to 1 to k as it is, ni also as it is. This is a square, that is epsilon I dot bar square plus b square epsilon double dot bar square minus 2 into epsilon I dot bar epsilon double dot bar. So now next step is we will multiply the summation I equals to 1 to k ni to the all the terms. Summation I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon I dot bar square plus summation I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon double dot bar square minus. So here 2 into, we are going to write the first 2 into epsilon double dot bar, you write as it is. In place of epsilon I dot bar, we have written in the, before starting the expectations, we have written some formulas for taking terms of have to multiply summation. Let's first multiply summation. I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon I dot bar. Now in place of this summation ni into epsilon I dot bar, we will substitute the values. So first value is as it is. Summation I equals to 1 to k ni into epsilon I dot bar square plus. So we know that summation I ni is nothing but capital N epsilon double dot bar square minus 2 into epsilon double dot bar. And this is the value of capital N into epsilon double dot bar. So since N into epsilon double dot bar equals to summation over I equals to K, Ni into epsilon I dot bar. We have written the formulas before only. So this term is as it is plus N into epsilon double dot bar square minus 2n into epsilon double dot bar square. Now, first term you write as it is. Now, n into epsilon double dot bar square minus 2n into epsilon double dot bar square is minus n into epsilon double dot bar square. So this is the expectation of sum of squares due to treatment value. Now we substitute the expectation values. Sorry, this is not the expectation value. We have considered this term, right? So this is only since part we have. So the last step we got it as expectation of sum of squares into treatment. The first term we had is summation I equals to 1 to k n I into alpha I square. Next second term we got it as this term, that is summation plus summation I equals to 1 to k n I. So this term we are going to apply the expectation, right? Expectation of E I dot bar square minus n into expectation of E double dot bar square. And the third term, it is 0 we got. So now we will substitute the expectation of E I dot bar square value and expectation of E double dot bar square value also. So all the expectation values we have find. So we will substitute those expected values. The expectation of sum of squares due to treatment equals to first term summation I equals to 1 to k n I into alpha I square plus summation I equals to 1 to k n I, you write as it is. And expectation of E I dot bar square value we got it as sigma E square by n I minus capital N into expectation of E double dot bar square. E double dot bar square value we got it as sigma E square by capital N. Now capital N gets cancelled, Ni and Ni gets cancelled. This is equals to summation I equals to 1 to k Ni into alpha I square plus, so yeah, summation I equals to 1 to k, total k terms. So k into sigma E square minus sigma E square. So this is equals to summation I equals to 1 to k ni alpha I square plus, if you take out sigma E square common you will get k minus 1. So this is the value of expectation of sum of squares due to treatment. So for this sum of squares we will divide with the degrees of freedom. So what is the degrees of freedom for the treatment sum of squares? K minus 1. So expectation of sum of squares due to treatment divided by degrees of freedom k minus 1 is equal to first term 1 by k minus 1 summation I equals to 1 to k n I into alpha I square plus here k minus 1 gets cancelled. So sigma e square. So sum of squares divided by its degrees of freedom is nothing but the expectation of small t square. That is mean sum of squares. So expectation of mean sum of squares due to treatment is equals to 1 by k minus 1 summation I equals to 1 to k n I alpha I square plus sigma e square. So since under null hypothesis what we have written, since under H naught we have written that alpha 1 equals to alpha 2 equals to so on equals to alpha k equals to 0, right? So this term will become 0 now, that is alpha I square value will become 0. So expectation of small st square equals to sigma e square. So what does it mean? The mean sum of squares due to treatment is the unbiased estimator for sigma e square. So what is unbiased estimator? Expectation of a statistic equal to the parameter value. So expectation of what? Mean sum of squares due to treatment. So that's why this mean sum of squares due to treatment is the unbiased estimator for, what is the answer we got? Sigma e square. So this is the